Hey, welcome back to Minecraft Through the Night, Season 6, Crowscroft. And I'm coming to you today by voiceover. My audio did not record correctly in this episode. And, well, it's a long story. Options, video settings, particles, all. Because Minecraft was not my problem. The mods were not my problem. The problem was Avast antivirus software. That's what was causing all of my tick lag. Oh my goodness. Let's go up here. What do I want? Have I got diamond leggings? I want diamond. Not a pick. I don't know I'm going to use that pick, actually. I kind of like to deconstruct it and get those diamonds back, to be honest. Isn't it weird that Minecraft comes down to the search for blue stuff, the search for diamonds, search for lapis, search for cobalt. It's always the blue stuff, man. Blue slime. Cave crystals. Or whatchamacallem. Oh, what a lovely day. Lovely day here in Minecraft and a lovely day in Oklahoma City. It's Thursday, May the 6th. 2021. Beautiful evening. I am pleased to tell you that I've had a wonderful little, I call it a breakthrough, I guess, in my jogging life. And today I went out for a 5K jog. I was seriously thinking about going for a 10K jog today. In fact, had planned on it. But also have learned to pay attention to my body, you know? There comes a point where, you know, one learns to pay attention. So, I did. And instead of running two big loops around my neighborhood, I just ran one, at least to start with. And the cleaver has a longer reach than the pickaxe. How about that? Look at that. Interesting. And so I just ran, jogged 5K. And it's the same thing I've talked with you about previously. The low heart rate running, which basically says, it's like, dude, if your heart rate gets above X, then slow down and walk until it gets below X. And so that's what it did. In my case, I'm experimenting with a heart rate of, between heart rate limits between 120 and 140 beats per minute, which is probably the rule of thumb is for a man who's 20 years younger than me. That would be the heart rate. Okay, we're working on the roof here. And what I have decided after reflection, I think I want the glazed terracotta to bump out more I want the jasper to be recessed and the lighting to be recessed and the glazed terracotta to be the ceiling level, if that makes any sense. So let's make a little scaffold of sorts to make this go easier. So so I went out for a nice 5K jog. I felt my stomach rumbling a bit, and I thought, well, it's no fun to be out in the middle, you know, of a long jog and have to answer the call of nature. So I just ran 5K today. 2 days ago, yesterday, I took the day off. I did not run yesterday. I don't think I even walked. Yeah, I didn't even walk yesterday. But 2 days ago, I ran 6.5 miles, or about 11 kilometers. Far in excess of my goal for that day. And I simply wanted to just have a nice run at the lake near my house. It's just a 20-minute drive. Trailhead, the place that I run, just basically a 20-minute drive from my house. Ideally, it'd be a walk from my house. And you know what? As I went there, I looked and the... there are plenty of houses in the neighborhood that are within. I could like buy a house or rent a house that would, in fact, be. I could jog out my front door and be at the lake. And those are not expensive houses either. It's you know, house prices are not terribly expensive here in Oklahoma. So. All that to say, had an unexpectedly long 6.5 mile jog on Tuesday, 2 days ago, and followed it up with an off day yesterday. Today I had a lovely 5 kilometer jog earlier this afternoon, and I'm thinking about going out again today, getting another 5K in, and having a another 10 kilometer day today. So I don't know. I'm still thinking about it. It's gonna be nighttime, dog. What you gonna do? What you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you? Feels really good. My ankle problems that I used to have, I'm not saying they're cured, but for the most part, they're not the worst of my troubles right now. Those old ankle problems. I think I talked in season 4, Introvert Island. I think I talked about this pretty extensively, but just to recap, I used to be quite a amateur runner, a hobbyist runner, if you will. I did run a bit of track in high school, and I did. I was fast. Won some in an eighth grade track meet. I won a blue ribbon in I think 100 meter and 200 meter. But my coach was worried because I was pale as a sheet, you know, after those runs. I could run fast, but it was a I guess he was afraid I was going to keel over and die or something. So there was a guy on our squad, I can't remember his name, and this is going to sound terrible, but we called him Cherokee because he was native. His family was native tribe, and nice guy, and I wonder how he's doing these days. Cherokee, hope you're doing all right, bud. I'll be honest, I don't even remember his real name. We always called him Cherokee. He seemed okay with it, but then he was an eighth grader. I mean, what did he know, right? So... I'm telling you this, and I didn't. This was not the point of my story. Let's go sleep through this night. Which night is this? And there's a backup. Which night is this? Day 251. About 250. I have been lately acquiring some interesting and useful tidbits for my walk-in excursions that I do. Honestly, I don't really absolutely need them. Namaste, good morning, sun. Namaste to the new day. To the new day. Love it. I love that word, namaste. Man, love it. Noi tells me it's a Hindu word, Indian word, not proper Thai, but only because she was correcting me because I used it sort of in a context of Thai culture, and I was a little bit disappointed that she corrected me. I thought she would love it, but she's big on authenticity. You know, authentic, whatever. I don't know. I love Tex-Mex food. I love Mexican food too. Mex-Mex food, but. And I love Okie-Mex food. And I love Okie-Tex food. I mean, I love food. I love people. I love cultures. And, I mean, there's a mixed family living right next door to me, you know, half Mexican, half Euro white vanilla, and they're lovely people, you know, and I got no beef with that, man. Mixed culture, good culture. People gonna be people. People gonna people, you know what I mean? That looks pretty good. I like that. Let's let that kind of sit. I'm kind of thinking about recessing that outline as well. Here, let's do a little bit of... Let's go ahead and fix up this outline. Not recessed. I think it's important, this one, not to be recessed. Because what's underneath will be... That line of stone underneath, I think it's going to be a marble maybe. I don't know what the accent should be for that center, these inserts we have underneath, insets. What a beautiful day in Oklahoma City it is. It was a beautiful day yesterday, and we actually had rain yesterday evening. I couldn't believe it. I was playing some Minecraft, and I had seen the forecast, and it called for rain, and I was like, I'm a skeptical dude, and I didn't believe it, but it did. It rained. We're having beautiful spring-like weather today, high of 70 degrees. It was a lovely 5K run day. Okay, I think that's enough, dog. Enough for this episode. Enough for today. Let's go down. Let's go looking for some diamond. These ferroflare lanterns, as much as I love them, I almost was ready to take them down because I thought the tick lags might be coming from them. Thought it might be coming from this ender pump. The pump. But no, not coming from the pump. Oh, yeah. I love this. I don't know if you noticed it, but the pump is at radius 32 or something, 34. God, I love this music. And I'm wondering here why that lava source block did not get picked up by the pump. And it takes me a few minutes. You can see that my head is at Y position 11. And the pump is working at Y position, let's see, 6, 3, 2, 1, 10. The pump is sitting at Y level 10. And that's where it starts. It goes from its lateral location, its Y location, and goes downward to zero, to Y equals zero. So it missed all the lava source blocks that are elevated above Y level 10. And right here, I'm doing some calculation. I think I decided the source block must be at Y level 19. And I mean, I could simply raise the pump to Y level 19 or 20, but then it would have to do double the work. It would only pick up a few random source blocks, like that raised one, for double the work, double the time, half the speed, however you want to say it. So I think I eventually decided to leave well enough alone and not mess with it. I'll go block that one up if I need to, if it's bothering me. And it is. I'll go block it up in another time. But the pump is working great. And the pump is not causing lag. These flare lanterns are not causing lag. I've read that they cause lag to begin with, but of course they do to begin with, as they're setting up and calculating the light levels. So let's look for some diamond. Let's carve out a few of these little areas here and see if we can find a bit of diamond, a bit of diamond. Because I want to make some leggings, some blue leggings for myself. Hey, spider in the darkness. Spider in the spotlight. Tiger in the Spotlight. Great song by Emerson, Lake, and Palmer. Freeze. You shaking at the knees. Please. Da-da-da-da-dee. I love the lyrical. Greg Lake's lyrical. At his best, Greg Lake's lyrical compositions are just dovetail so beautifully. Love it. Oh, I made another change, and I'm going to demonstrate it here in just a minute. This mod pack, I added something to it. After realizing, after I uninstalled Avast, Avast antivirus, I uninstalled, and it was scary. But I kept thinking about a conversation I had with my son, who's involved in corporate IT. Here we go. Here's a demonstration of what I just installed. Boop. Not zombification. It's called ore excavation. I did have Miner's Advantage installed, and I deactivated. I've still got the jar file, but the developer hasn't maintained it in quite some time, and it's complex. It's a lot. It has so many options. It's smarter than I am, and so I never have felt entirely comfortable using Miner's Advantage, so I uninstalled it, and I found that Ore Excavator had been released just a few weeks ago, and it is one of the vein miner type mods that has never caused me, knock on wood, I've used it in the past and it has not caused me a performance issue. It's lightweight and it's for a dumb guy like me. It works great. Not a whole lot of config options to worry about. And I like that. It's a lightweight mod for a lightweight guy. So, Now, what about Avast? So Aura Excavator is the latest addition to my mod, to my personal mod pack here. Watch it eat away this redstone. The other side to that, if I should finish this for you, because I made some comments. I was pretty happy that Tinker's Construct added a vein hammer, which takes care of all this stuff. But inadequately for me. I found myself still... I didn't use my vein. I had to carry around another tool, the vein hammer itself, and it had such a limited area of use, and there were no config files that I could find to make it do its thing like I wanted to. So that was the other part of it. I had already decided to go back to Miner's Advantage, and when I saw that Ore Excavator had been released over on CurseForge, had been updated, I thought, well, I'll try it out. And in my offline world, I've been playing and testing Minecraft quite a bit, test these mods that I add. In my offline world, I needed XP. And so I found that Ore Excavator was great for racking up the XP quickly, you know, when there was a vein of redstone or coal. And so I kind of proved it in over there on my offline world. And anyway, I still love Tinker's Construct. I every intention of keeping it. I mean, Tinker's Construct is dear to my heart, as I'm sure it's dear to your heart too. But Ore Excavation is where it's at today, baby. And I don't want to leave you hanging about the Avast thing. I had a conversation with my son, who works in corporate IT. In fact, cybersecurity, corporate IT now. He's one of the lead IT people at his workplace, at his very large workplace, involved in cybersecurity. And we had a conversation where he said, you know, Windows Defender is not so bad. It's pretty good. And I was kind of shocked. Because years ago, Windows Defender was not the... Oh, gosh, Silverfish. Windows Defender was not a complete antivirus solution. Well, it's pretty highly ranked now. I think they're Kaspersky and... Let me think. BitPusher or something like that are the two highest ranked free antiviral tools, but Bit Threshold, maybe that's what it is. I can't remember. But anyway, Windows Defender was ranked number 3 out of... I can't remember what website I trusted for that analysis, but in combination with what my son had said, it was enough for me. So I thought, I'm going to uninstall Avast antivirus and go naked into that good night. And I did. And it was so scary. And what was even scarier was that no sooner had I... So last night I uninstalled Avast and shut down my computer. Completely shut it down. And this morning, when I got up, I turned on my computer and my PC, desktop PC, and it said, Windows needs to, you're out of date. Windows needs to update. And I was like, oh no, this can't be coincidence. What happened? What have I done? Have I got a Trojan? Have I got something that's trying to get itself into my registry? You know, the typical paranoia, those really quick paranoia moments you have. Well, it turned out to be just a genuine, bona fide Windows 10 May you know, may release. And everything's working great. I uninstalled Avast and it gave me all these dire warnings. Are you sure you want to be unprotected? You're at risk, dog. And I'm like, oh, okay, I'm going to try it. You know, it's probably the first time in 8, 10, 12, 15 years I have not been using either Avast or AVG antivirus. And it's amazing. It's amazing that Windows has an embedded product. You know, Windows 10, it's costly enough, right? And now they have this amazing embedded product that is constantly updated and takes care of the threats. And you don't have to buy anything else. It's amazing, amazeballs. So, I am pretty happy. I'm pretty blissed, actually, about that. And, I mean, this episode of Minecraft Through the Night, I don't know what to say except it just works. No lag spikes. All that optimization I've done and the graphics drivers, and I still, asterisk, I think I still have a problem with the graphics driver from Radeon AMD. To the point that I was looking at NVIDIA video cards, but it's not right time, man. Silicon expensive. I'll wait on that. And with that, we're going to bring this episode to a close. I'll see you next time for Minecraft Through the Night.